Thanks for joining me on this video. We're going to get the water heater compartment put in, the 110 volt inlet coming into the trailer, and also do the entire fridge compartment. So there you go. There's the finished product right there. And we're going to show you how.
I've got the water heater floor installed. I've laminated it together with the construction adhesive. A number of screws holding it down, and I've reinstalled the bolt holding the trailer to the. And Rosie's inspecting the work. Did it do a good job, Rosie? Is it gonna hold? Got the water heater in place, and I've cut these blocks just to help stabilize it. So I'll mark them and screw them down, and that should make the water heater pretty stable. Now that I've got the water heater fitted into place, I've started working on the cabinet. So I've put all this framing around here so I can put a shelf on here. There's also going to be a panel going here, dividing this area. The drawers are right here. And I've yet to decide what I'm going to do with this cabinet. The microwave may go here, but it's a nice large area to make an awesome place for storage. This is where the oven was. I don't have faith in that oven right now, so I'm pretty sure I'm not putting it back in place, because right there is some more of that burn mark from it. Now, in fitting all this stuff, I cut a nice square panel for this divider here, and of course I put it in and I went, oh yeah, that's what you get for assuming things are square. Nothing's square in here, so now it's got a lot of adjustments on it, but it fits now. So I will get cutting more things and give you an update when I got more to update you on.
This board I'm putting in place here, I'm going to glue it as well as staple it. And this board here is original board. It was quite dirty, so I sanded it and then blown off the sawdust to make it adhere better. And in referring to the not square thing, just in case you're wondering, it was out an eighth of an inch. It wasn't like it was out half an inch, so it's not hugely out of square, but that panel didn't fit the way I wanted it to when it came to the part where you're going to see it. So that's what I had to adjust. Okay, the cabinet's coming together. I've got the sidewall in and the bottom. The bottom I'm going to screw into place. That will give me really good access to the water heater anytime I need it. This sidewall does not come up right to the bottom of the counter, because the stove meets this. This is not behind the stove. So this is just below the stove. This back panel here is going to be covered or replaced, because that round hole is where the power is coming in. It's not coming in there anymore. And then that upper hole there is where the rest of that door was, that who knows what the original purpose of that was, but it's not going to be put there anymore. And then where the power is going to come in is right here between the water heater and the wheel well, and that is nice and close to the power converter and power center, so that's going to work really well. It's coming together pretty good. I'm so happy to be building and not just destructing anymore. We're going the right direction. We're over the hump. I am getting close to being done on the cabinet above the water heater. So as I mentioned before, I was going to put the electrical in. So it was up here and it's now down here. Put a block in to screw everything to and make it very solid, because that's the last thing you want being loose is your electrical, especially your 30 amp supply. So I haven't got this screwed down because I got to put the metal on over first, but this will give me an idea how much cable I need and be able to get everything wired in. I put more framing in to be a backing for the interior panel because there was nothing supporting it above this board. And this little indentation is because I put the new panel over top of the old panel. Figured that would, at the very least, make it stronger, and it also was just plain easier. And you can see it's covering up that. So inside the compartment, you can see I've got the back wall panel on. And there's the electrical coming in there, and then the floorboard goes on here, like this. So it just falls in place here. Can't say it isn't a tight fit. So that cupboard's together, coming together quite nicely. Next, gonna start working on the fridge compartment. And as you can see, I was picking up some stuff today. That's why I didn't get a lot done. The sidewall vent and the roof vent. This is the roof vent for the fridge. Arrived. We've got the breakers for the power converter. Took a few stops to find those because they are an oddball. And the water tank fill and city water connection, switches for the ceiling lights and the porch light, and a bypass kit for the water heater. So tomorrow I've gonna get a lot done. I just keep thinking of more things I need for this trailer. So, but pretty soon we'll have it all. I've been working on the fridge cabinet at the moment. It doesn't look like I got a lot done, but I've got a lot of boards cut, measured, and it all figured out here. So to review, this cabinet has to be quite tight to the fridge to meet their specifications, mostly so carbon monoxide doesn't get into the living compartment. So this board here is, there'll be a board attached on the bottom here that's already cut for the top of the cabinet. Another board's going to go on top here. That is going to be the bottom of the what's remaining for this storage compartment here. I've got a board cut that's going to go up the back here. So that'll be like the chimney going up to the roof vent. And I've got it all marked out on top to cut it out. And then I'll have to do some framing up there to build supports for it to screw down to. Then I've cut a number of these uprights. So when these are installed and then the paneling is over top, I've cut them cut for both sides. That will give the cabinet the right width that we want. So it'll be very nice and tight in there. It's coming together nicely. The vent, I've got the sidewall vent, I've got that measured out for the width of there. I've got to cut that hole a little taller because of the size of the vent work. So just getting some details done on the cabinet. The fridge didn't come up to here before, so it was square here, but rounded over here. So I took the router bit and brought it the rounded corner up to where the top of the fridge is going to meet. Did that on both sides. And then the panel that is going at the back here, I've got this board installed here so that I can attach it to the back there. So that'll make it nice and rigid. And also that will give me something to attach a divider to up in the roof to continue this box up right up to the bottom of the vent. So I got the sander out and sanded down all this outside edges where the fridge is gonna go. Makes it a lot easier without the fridge in here. It got better access. The other thing is where the fridge was and where I did the routing, it, my bit was a little different than the bit they used at the factory 60 years ago.
so I could make that transition not noticeable now. So she's looking pretty good. Now, I'm gonna cut out that hole. The fridge roof vent is framed up on the outside, and it's gonna just fit on like that. It is the right size for the opening. It's gonna be awesome. Worked around the rafter. It's all gonna be good. Stapling the boards in place. And Rosie, the shop dog, is not liking it. Apparently she protests. The cabinet is mostly done. Here's the storage above. I've just got to make some trim pieces to go in here, similar to this one. And if you look up there, we've got the chimney for the roof vent. And then I've just got to make the sidewall vent fit. And then we can put the refrigerator in here, and the next step in this compartment would be running the propane and electricity in the 12 volt. The side trim is in. Looks good. Now on to the vent. The fridge sidewall vent is framed out. And you can see that I've got it stained, and that the reason for that is the vent in the winter, snow can get through here and accumulate in there. So that'll protect the wood from any snow accumulation. And then what I'll do is I'll just create a little dam here to stop any water from going that way to the unprotected part of the wood. The other nice thing about this compartment is the depth of the compartment for the refrigerator is just about ideal for where the air is going up. So it's not too wide, not too narrow. So next step is to install the refrigerator. So onward. Well, we made some good progress this week. Got that water heater compartment done, the cabinet above it, the fridge compartment done, all everything nicely finished. And so the next step is we're gonna start working on that furnace, get that boxed in and installed properly. And then we might tackle the toilet and the water tank, which are sitting right there, and get all the plumbing done. Then when we've got all that stuff in place, we can get back to the wiring. See you soon.